I'm just a Broadway baby, walking off my tired feet.
Oh my God, you guys. Welcome to episode 20 of Namaste and Broadway. Yay! I cannot believe... First of all, I can't believe that I actually stayed motivated to do Namaste on Broadway because I have so much going on with my life at the moment with, I have rehearsals for Cinderella that I actually just finished, and I have so much going on with, you know, I'm moving back to Connecticut so I can, you know, be closer to New York City with my dad, and so I'm just in the midst of all of that and, you know, getting a job and finding other theater auditions and things like that and trying to book auditions and professional shows. So I'm just busy doing that. So Namaste was on hold for a little while, but I'm back now. So I have decided that this will be the final episode of Namaste and Broadway for a long time. I'll resume it probably... I don't know, when everything brushes over and, you know, I'm either at college next fall or if I'm, you know, who knows? Just when everything just brushes over and calms down and I'm settled somewhere, you know, in New York City, then I'll resume it then. But for now, please enjoy the final episode of Namaste on Broadway. This is going to be the longest episode ever created of Namaste on Broadway. Probably going to be like 34 minutes or I don't know, something like that. But please enjoy Namaste on Broadway, and you'll actually get to see some of my Cinderella performance, hopefully, in this video. So please, Namaste on Broadway, enjoy episode 20 of Namaste on Broadway. Here's a quick recap of Namaste on Broadway.
Find you. Without them, the world grows dark around you, and nothing is the same until you know that they have found you.
Those you've paid may carry them still with them. All the same, they whisper all forgiven. The shadows bring the starlight, and everything you've ever been is still there in the dark night.
Though you know you've left them far behind, you walk on by yourself and not with them. Still you know they fill your heart and mind when they say, find you. They call you as if you knew their longing. They whistle through the lonely wind, the long blue shadows falling.
All alone, but still I hear their yearning. Through the dark, the moon alone they're burning. The stars too, they tell of spring returning. Summer with another wind that no one yet
You guys, guess what time it is? Camp Broadway look back! Woo! Woo! Let's do this!
So, I attended Camp Broadway for 5 years in a row, and this camp has changed my life for the better, and I don't know, I can't think of any better way to spend episode 20 of Namaste on Broadway, so let's get to it. So, for my first year of Camp Broadway, we did the show State Fair, and it was probably the cutest little show that I did in Camp Broadway, and I had so much fun, and Isaac Olson was my featured player, and I was a Jude Jampson, so here is my first name tag from Camp Broadway ever. I was Jude Jampson number 7, so that was fun. And now let's take a look at what baby Sarah looked like. And this was after 8th grade. That was the year before I went into high school. And every year, that year, we still were getting pins. So that was my first Camp Broadway pin I ever got. So, cute little me. And then we got 2 t-shirts every year. So this was my little t-shirt, my first year of Camp Broadway. And this one as well. So it's my 2 first ever Camp Broadway t-shirts. And actually today, 11/18/15, happens to be Camp Broadway t-shirt day. So I tweeted, Instagrammed the big picture of all my Camp Broadway stuff for Camp Broadway t-shirt day. So go check that out on Instagram. This was my first Camp Broadway DVD ever that came in, and I was so excited when it came in, and it came in around Thanksgiving. Every year it comes around in around Thanksgiving, so I watched this, and I was so excited about it, and it was probably the funnest time I ever had in my entire life the first year. So for my second year of Camp Broadway, we did the show My Fair Lady, and you might notice that this script is a different color. It's red, because I moved up to become a Nederlander, and the second year I happened to be Nederlander number 7, just like I was Jude Jampson number 7 the first year. And this is what I looked like my second year of Camp Broadway. That was my second pin that I got. I had a kind of transformation there a little bit. So yeah. And then this is what my t-shirt looked like. I grew a little bit, and I got 2 of them, but, so yeah, I grew a little bit that year, and that year, Anna Raffel happened to be my, my featured player, and she played Eliza Doolittle, and she was an amazing Eliza Doolittle. And also Joshua Olson, I think his name is, he played Eliza's dad. So that was very fun, and I have a lot of good friends from that year. So this was the second DVD that I got around Thanksgiving of 2012, and it's a different color, as you can see. It's like a magenta-ish purple, I guess. But yeah, this year was pretty fun too. So for my third year of Camp Broadway in 2013, we did Damn Yankees. This was a really fun show, and also Anna Raful happened to be my my featured player that year, and she played Lola, and this was my name tag. I was Nederlander number 2, and so that was a very, very fun show to do. I got to be a little devilette, and Joshua Olsen happened to be what's his name? Applegate that year, and so that was a very, very fun show, and I loved doing the mambo, and I loved saying, erp! Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? Who's got the pain when they go erp? Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? I don't know who. Do you? And then I did this, like, really cool, like, leg lift thing in it during Who's Got the Pain When They Do the Mambo? Who's Got the Pain When They Go Erp? Okay, so then this was my third year DVD, and it also came in around Thanksgiving. But it's orange this year. It was orange for this year, and it kind of goes with the theme of things, because we did Damn Yankees, and also the Pajama Games was the younger kids. So yeah, that was pretty fun. I'm also missing my picture from that year, and I'm really upset, because I think I had a huge transformation that year for Camp Broadway, so yeah. So then, for my fourth year of Camp Broadway, I was debating whether or not I was going to have it as my last year, but then my choreographer, Sue Delano, persuaded me to come back for my fifth year. But for my fourth year, we did Once on This Island, and boy, let me tell you, what a production that was. It was so much fun, and we, it was a lot of Afro-Haitian dance, and a lot of, you know, we had to speak like we were from the French Antilles, so the dialect was a little hard at first to start and learn it, but and we got one line each, but it was probably, I think, the funnest show I ever did at Camp Broadway, I have to say, because I had a lot of fun dancing, like, Afro-Haitian dancing, so it was a lot of, like, hip gestures, and, you know, like, ups, and it was like, and she stands against the lightning and the thunder, and she shelters and protects us from above, and, like, we had to articulate, the lyrics so good that so that they could understand the language, the accent, and so that they could understand what we were saying at the same time. So, like, when we were saying, why we tell this story, why we tell this story, we had to accentuate the Y, like, to sound like an A, story, story. It sounded a lot better in the DVD, so this is the DVD, and the fourth year, they happened to do Seussical the Musical for the younger kids, so it's kind of appropriate for it to be green, the Jungle of Newell and the French Antilles. So it was a lot of pastel-y kind of colors that year. But here's my picture. I don't know what my facial expression is in that picture. This was my, fourth, Camp Broadway thing. And that year, the year before, we actually started going, to patches and not, pins, which is kind of cool. So now, if we get a Camp Broadway, sweatshirt, we can, put the patches on it. So that's going to be a lot of fun when I get that. So yeah, and then this was my thing, my name tag for Once on This Island, and I happened to be a Dodger that year, so that was the first year I went into Dodgers, and Diego Rio was my featured player, and he played a storyteller in the beginning, because we did, Asaka, grow me a garden, please Agwe, don't flood my garden, Herzuli, who will my love be, Papage, don't come around me. So he played Agwe, because we did the song Rain. So we did, let there be no moon, let the clouds race by, where their road meets the sea, let the tide be high. And that was a lot of fun that year. And then finally, for my fifth and final year, and this year is actually pretty fun too, but not as fun as Once on This Island was. But I mean, it was a great way to end my Camp Broadway career. Or to have a closing out of my Camp Broadway as my final year. We did Hairspray Junior for my final year of Camp Broadway, and that was so fun. And actually, the bittersweet thing about that year, about this past year, was that Isaac Olsen, who was my first featured player, happened to be my last featured player as well. And I thought that was so sweet, and I was crying by the end of it, because he and I... We became really good friends, I would like to think. We became really good friends the first year that I did Camp Broadway, when he was my first featured player. And we had a lot of fun during Camp Broadway the first year, and also the last year was very fun as well. So it was kind of bittersweet. And so I was a Dodger the last year, obviously. So I was Dodger number 4. And yeah, so that was a lot of fun. And... this is what I look like my final year. I had just dyed my hair red, so my scalp literally looks like it's red. But I kind of got grown up a little bit, you think? From 2014 year? I think so. And then this was my patch, from this past year. And, yeah. And we were celebrating 20 years for Camp Broadway at Providence. So yeah. Or I think in general, actually, it's 20 years of Camp Broadway, which was insanely awesome to have that be my last year, the 20th year of Camp Broadway. So that was pretty cool. And then this was a DVD for Camp Broadway. It's like a navy blue this year. Which kind of, I don't really think it goes with the theme, but I still think it was very fun. And these shirts that I got this year for Camp Broadway, I have not worn these yet. So these are brandy new t-shirts. And yeah, so that's pretty much Camp Broadway from Sarah Brewley this year, these past 5 years. So that's what I did with my... talented musical self, I guess I should say, that I put all my years towards Camp Broadway for the past 5 years, and Camp Broadway has really helped me grow as an actress, as a person. It's a great way of disciplining yourself, so you they teach you how to be a professional in this business, but it also teaches you discipline in real life, and it teaches you a lot of things. So now, to sign off, let's pick a card, a word, an angel card, and I want you guys to take this word and take it into your life, and for the rest of the year, because there's only 38 days until Christmas. Oh my God. but I want you to take this word, and I want you to try and live by it for the rest of the year. There's only 38 days left, just about. So up until January 1st, please use this word as best as you can. And please, 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 stay safe, everyone, and I love you guys, and let's pray for world peace together, because we really need it right now. So I want you guys to live by this word that I have in my hand right now. I haven't looked at it yet. But we're going to take this word and we're going to use it to our power. So let's see what it is. Creativity. So, does everybody see that? Creativity. I want you guys to be creative in any way you can. Any way possible that you can be creative. Any way that you see you can be creative. Whether it's in art or theater or being an engineer. Any way you see creative. Be creative. Creativity. So now, as we always say, and for a final time. Oh man, let's do this for a final time. Let's do this all together. I want you to do this with me. Okay, guys? You at home, do this with me. You ready? Namaste. And don't forget to keep up with Broadway. I hope you guys have an amazing life. Keep up with me on my Instagram page, official Sarah Brule, SARAHBRULE, and also Namaste and Broadway, NamasteAndBroadway. Please keep up with me there. And also, my new Instagram account is Sarah's, so SARAHS, Broadway Life, BROADWAYLIFE. So please keep up with me on those three Instagram accounts. I love you all, and I am so grateful that I got to do Namaste and Broadway, and I hope more people watch my vlog episodes 1 through 20 now on YouTube. Please, please, please check it out and keep up with me. Namaste, and don't forget to keep up with Broadway, because Broadway is cool, you guys. Bye, guys.
I'm just a Broadway baby, walking off my tired feet.
What do you want, Petey? What do you want? What do you want? Show me what you want. Show me what you want. Show me what you want. You want food?
I love you. I love
you. Boomer.
You want me to help, Rose?
No. Thank you. No, thank you.
What do you want me to do?
What about yourself?
I call you mom. What? Please. I feel so loved and protected by all of you. Wait, you want to call all of us mom? That's insane.
I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face. I'm enthused.
There's a part I can't tell about the dark I know well. You say time for bed now, child. Mom just smiles that smile.